sides agreed on what was fair and what would move these cases most efficiently, and that included confidentiality requests that I think were largely at the request of TWIA, but not disagreed on by the plaintiffs. Do I remember that right?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yes.
Okay.
You're never going to get a case settled if no one will show their hand, and no one will show their hand if you know the next thing is going to be out in the media or thrown in front of a jury when you're trying to candidly have a conversation. Okay, so you're taking two groups that are in an adversary process, and I believe I didn't write the ADR statute, Your Honor, but my understanding of it is you've taken two groups that are in adversary process and providing a shield over which to have these communications. It's ridiculous that we're here. We're here today after 180 hearings down here probably, wasting our time.
Let me ask you this. Your request today is going to be to ask me to not turn anything over?
My request today, Your Honor, will be a chance. They changed horses they were riding, okay? On September 8th, they were riding the I'm a legislator committee chairman under my purview as a legislator to request information. And then on September 17th, they changed horses that I'm Joe Q. Citizen requesting information, but I can't afford any other paper other than what the state gives me, so I'll put it on my legislator letterhead. And they request that information.
So you're asking me to deny it in total?
I'm asking you...
Because of the form of it now.
I'm asking for another TRO on this request. I'm going to ask for a chance for us to brief up what Mr. Busby probably wants to talk about, which is the Open Records Act isn't universal, and it says that it doesn't pierce through other privacy records that are confidential by statute or other law.
We all know what's going on here. This is politics at its rawest form. And now, if it wasn't, why would they be asking? Why would Larry Taylor? I say they because it's not Larry. Larry's the guy that wrote the letter or signed the letter. Somebody else wrote that for Larry, I assure you. We would not be here but for the fact that Mr. Mauston is a heavy Democratic donor. I try to stay out of politics now for obvious reasons. But now I have 300 or 400 clients who are caught up in this foolishness.
And we certainly object to entering another TRO because we believe that the process, there's a Public Information Act process whereby you respond to ask the Office of Attorney General to give an opinion, and then if either side is concerned about that, then they appeal that opinion based.
But your position is sort of more like, well, we think we should, but we're checking just as a cautionary thing. So there's a little fear of what if you decided we don't need that AG's opinion, we're just going to turn it over.
If they want to seek an AG opinion, seek an AG opinion. If not, then we're going to ask you to rule on it. But in the meantime, I don't want an oops. Oops, we let it out. Oops, we disclosed it.
I'm going to grant a new one. Do you already have it drafted, Mr. Monster, or do you need to do that?
I need to do that, Your Honor. I know Ms. Michaela, she catches me, helps me even sometimes. So I will send it to her, and we'll have it to you by 1 or 2 o'clock. Yeah, I don't want to even get close to 5, so is 2 o'clock good?
That's fine.